Hello, hello. What are your names?
I am Fenton, and this is Woody, and we are an aerial acrobatic duo.
Ooh, okay. And where do you usually perform?
Our act has mainly kind of been performed for more queer spaces, so okay. This is the first time that we've been performing it for a mainstream live audience.
Ah, I love that. Also, my name is Lilly Singh, and this is a queer space. So, what does this piece mean to you? What's a story you want to tell?
So when I started circus, I had a lover called Dan, and this piece is, it's called Goodbye Daniel. I had to leave him to start my dream, and sadly I didn't know that he was feeling a lot of horrible things, and he ended up taking his own life, and I never got to say goodbye, so for me this is my goodbye letter to him.
Well, what an honor for us to be able to see it then. Good luck, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
I fell by the wayside, like everyone else. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. Our every moment, I started a place. Cause now that the corner, I hear the words that I needed to say. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this won't. So
sparking up these cigarettes won't stop me wondering where you are. Don't let go, keep a hope. If you look into the distance, there's a house upon the hill, guiding like a lighthouse to place where you'll
amazing. Can I just say something? You know, I've seen a lot of aerialists throughout my career, but this is probably one of the most emotionally clear, beautiful, elegant stories that I have ever seen. I know what Daniel meant to you and what this moment meant to you. That was impeccably perfect.
Thank you so much. That means so much.
I honestly don't even know what to say because my heart is literally beating through my chest right now. That was so beautiful. It really was so beautiful. Oh, sorry. I'm so in my feels right now. You know, you came out here and you said, we usually perform in queer spaces, and that got me thinking, like, so many people out there are in spaces where they don't feel welcome. And I know that feeling as well. And I think one of the driving forces for my career has to try to make it so more spaces feel comfortable for people. And so this is because you are talented. This is for you. This is for everyone at home. And this is for Dan as well.
I can't thank you enough. This means so much to us, but so much to so many people. It's...
I said it before, but I'm gonna say it again. This is a queer space. Hello.
Hello, hello.
What is your name?
My name is Jack Thomas.
And what do you do?
I play music.
Love that. Have you brought some people to support you?
I really wish my mom was here. She really, really wanted to be here, but unfortunately just couldn't. I grew up in Port Coquitlam with my older brother, older sister, and my mom. My mom was a big music fan, so I've been submerged in music since I was, like, born. My mom is the music fanatic in our family. She pushed me towards learning music. Picked up bass guitar when I was 10, and then from there, my life kind of just took off. We weren't the most financially stable family, so when I was 17, I started working at a drywall dump. September 4th, 2015, I was doing some maintenance on one of the conveyor belts. It was a bit faulty, and it turned on while I was inside of it. I was completely by myself. I had nobody else around to help me. I didn't really have a fighting chance. I ran outside, I ran past my coworker, and he drained in color like a cartoon character, completely white. And he said, "I'm sorry, buddy, but your arm is gone." I was 17 at the time. I'm a musician who needs all of their limbs to play the instrument that they play, and everything I'd worked towards was with the goal of having a career and life in music. And at that point, I believed it was it. I was done. It was over. I'm never gonna be able to do this again. Elephant in the room, I'm missing a limb, and this was an accident, unfortunately. And when that happened, I thought that my career in music was completely over. And then I decided, no, it's not over. I'm gonna keep playing. And the first song I thought of was All the Small Things. And 8 days after my accident, I was on a drum kit playing that exact song.
Wow.
And
wow.
So I figured this is a full circle moment for me.
Oh, man. Well, Jack, I wish you the best of luck. I'm really rooting for you. The stage is yours.
Thank you so much. I hope you all enjoy.
Thank you.
Oh, you just had it. You just owned that stage. You owned the music. You had the crowd.
Everybody in life, regardless of what they do, have hurdles to go through. You not only showed up, but you excelled. The only thing that I feel bad, and because I'm a parent, that your mom is not in the room to see you.
She really, really wishes she could be here, but hey.
Call her.
Let's call her.
Come down here so we can talk to her and see her too.
Let's call mom.
Hello.
Hi. You're talking to a lot of people right now.
Okay, hi everyone.
This is Howie Mandel now. I just watched your son.
How did he like it?
I loved it.
He's pretty awesome.
I gotta say that he just rocked the room, he rocked the show, and the only negative I have is you weren't here to see it.
Since you weren't here to see the performance and see how 5,000 people were on their feet, how about you stick around for the vote? I'm gonna give you your first yes. One yes.
That was Trish Stratus.
I'm Lilly Singh. Hi, Mom. And I'm going to give you your second yes.
It is Kardinal Offishall, and I am giving the third yes.
But you know what? He's got four yeses, and he's going on.
Hello. What's your name?
Jean-Pierre Parrin.
And where are you from?
I am from Montreal.
Okay. And what do you do?
I am a magician.
How long have you been doing that?
When I was 20 years old, an agent came to me and said, you want to go on a cruise ship for the winter? So in Montreal, it's very cold. I was like, yes, let's do it. So it was supposed to be just 4 months, and it ended up being 25 years now. So.
Oh,
wow.
It seems like a pretty sweet deal. Why come to Canada's Got Talent?
You know, I want to establish myself more, a little bit more on land, and be... Be more with my family, my girlfriend, you know.
The things we do for love.
I know, right?
We're all super excited to see what you do.
Thank you.
He seems nervous.
From? I'm from Ukraine.
And I'm from Russia.
Whoa.
And today we will dance for Ukraine.
I love that.
That's wonderful.
That's beautiful.
We want to show the love between us. We want to show the love of dance. And we want to show the love for Ukraine.
Now is your moment.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good luck.
That's cool.
change. The engine is running, the road is calling.
That was incredible. Wow. It was so like sexy, but like athletic and just so graceful. Beautiful. Well done, guys.
Thank you.
You guys switched it up and were able to dance to different genres of music. At first, I was like, huh. But then by the end of it, I was like, huh.
I am aroused. You, sir, are very hot. And you are so hot also.
This is my hot Ukrainian wife.
But also, underneath it all, I couldn't help thinking, in light of what's happening now, it just shows you that war is tearing the world apart. And two people, a Russian and a Ukrainian, coming together to make each one better than they would be alone, kind of exemplifies what the world needs to do. That was a great symbol of love, of unity.
We're all humans, and we should be kind for a better future of younger generation.
Beautiful.
So, for not only what we just saw, but also for what you stand for and your message, you get your first yes from me.
Thank you. Thank
you. You absolutely get a yes from me.
Thank you.
It is a yes for me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And you absolutely get a yes, sir!
Four yes, sir. Good evening. Who are you? What's your name?
I'm Bronwyn Hart Irwin.
I'm Jason Irwin.
Don't tell me what you're gonna do, because I see there's a setup behind you, and I love surprises.
Good luck.
Thanks, guys.
Strippers. Dancers, wrestling. I think wrestling.
Does this look like your world?
It's similar to mine because of the ring, but no, we have more rope. Maybe they're gonna hang clothes.
Laundry? We're about to see laundry.
My mom would be so impressed if it was laundry.
You know how we do it, baby? Yeah. Keep it so fresh. Fell out the saddle a few times. Had to get back on. Got up on my grind. Yeah, got my bottle of moonshine. Haters to keep hating, we paying them no mind.
Hello. Wow. Hi.
Hello.
What's your name?
Kern Dobbs.
And where are you from, Kern?
I'm from Victoria.
And what do you do there?
I do stand-up comedy.
How long have you been doing it?
10 years, 10 months, 2 weeks, and 2 days.
Wow. To be exact.
Very specific.
Wonderful. I wish you the best of luck, young man.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Good evening, ladies.
It's funny.
So, I'm on the autistic spectrum, so if I seem rude or weird, or if I'm not making eye contact, I just want you to know it's because I really feel like you're not worth the effort. I was doing a gig a while back. I didn't make it clear that I was autistic when I was making jokes about it, and someone went up to the producer of the show and asked him if I was autistic or if I was drunk. Fun fact, you can be both. And stoned. When I was in grade 12, I took a vocational assessment to see what kind of jobs I could do. And on the results we got back, there's a graph with a bunch of different intellectual areas. And in a lot of them, I scored pretty high in. The one I scored low in was processing speed. So I'm brilliant. I just take my time getting there. Ladies.